Sanjar and Mavi are sharing their pain on the boat. Sanjar asks, how much time? Mavi says, 6 months. It was a traffic accident. Karaman scolded his worker that he did not do a single thing properly. Alicia comes. Karaman asks, what happened, madam? Your son is not there, so you are controlling his business. She said, no, I come to talk to you when you are going to take her. He says, I don't need, cause your son has already started journey with her. Here Mavi and Sanjar begins their journey, but they face a problem with police. Sanjar says, if you want, I will take you from here. I will come back and face punishment. But Mavi refuses. Police arrive. Mavi is accused of using a fake captain certificate. Police ask Mavi to come to the station. Sanjar also sits in the car with Mavi. Sanjar says, we are both friends of the whale. What if we can't go to Posa? Let's go to police station together. In the mansion, Elvan plays with Jailan's child. Jailan says, in such a big mansion, Sanjar's daughter has become alone. So who will be with my child? Elvan says, everyone will live together, don't worry. In the police station, Sanjar tells Mavi that even fate wants you not to go from here. Mavi says, what are you doing here? Sanjar says, what? Did I do something wrong? She says, no. You are Sanjar FA. Many people need you. Sanjar says, I have told my entire story. You still think I am able to help someone? I lost two of my dears in 1 week. One is my dear friend and the other is my 20-year-old love. I thought that I could not save them, but I will help you and save you. You need me. But now I feel like that you don't need me, but I need you. Dudu tells to Yaya, have you talked to your brother about company's share? He says not yet because he is busy. She says, yes, he is busy with that woman affair. Everyone is saying how soon Sanjar has forgotten Nare. Sanjar calls Elvan and asks about Melek. Elvan says, don't worry, she is playing with the baby right now. Kaur comes to station with some food packets. Sanjar is very angry at himself. He says that everything has happened because of me. He says, if I had not followed her, today she would not have been in the police station because of me. Kavruk says, don't worry, there is goodness in everything. Melek is very sad. Melek says to baby, I am very sad but do not show to my father. Sanjar brings food. He says, I told Kavruk that he should bring you sushi, but he brought it. People from big city don't know how to eat it. Mavi taunts him and says, yeah, I really don't know how to eat it, even though I had not seen this before. She wraps one and gives it to him. Sanjar asks her, where do you live? What do you do? She says, I have been in a corporate company for years as an administrator. Again he asks, where is your mom and dad? She says, even the police do not inquire like you. He says, I am not interrogating you. I just wanted to talk while eating. She says, yes, I grew up with my mother and grandmother, but lost them too. He asks, any sibling? She says, do not worry, I am not any wanted criminal. I left Istanbul after losing my child. I do not like that place anymore. Mavi is ordered by the court that she has to appear in the station every week. Alisa reaches the court with Melek. Melek and Mavi are introduced. Alisa invites Mavi to mansion, but Mavi agrees to come later. But Melek put her hand on Mavi's shoulder and says, please come with us today only. Mavi cannot refuses her and says okay. On the dinner table, Melek asks her, when will you go from here? Mavi says, don't know, I'm here for a few days. Alisa always tries to say something on dinner table. Sanjar feels awkward. Melek is not feeling good. Alisa asks Elvan to take her to bed. Elvan tells Melek, let's give you a glass of warm milk and I will tell you the story also. Hearing this, Mavi's heart becomes restless. Sanjar says to Melek, I will take you. Melek asks Sanjar, Dad, did you paint our heart with blue because of this lady? Because her name is Mavi. Mavi means blue in Turkish. Sanjar says, no, you like blue color and your eyes are also blue. That's why I painted our heart blue. Melek did not like that Mavi lived in that heart and she took a promise from Sanjar that from now this heart is only belong to of us and no one will live there. Alisa and Mavi sitting together. Alisa asks Mavi, did you and Sanjar stay together? Mavi says, Whether we stay together or not, it's only concern two of us. Nobody else has anything to do with it. Mavi gets fed up with Alice's question and leaves from there. Sanjay goes after her and says sorry for his mother's behavior. Then Sanjay comes back to mansion and told everything about Mavi to his mother. Kavu comes to meet Sanjay, he says, "Don't worry, don't be so upset. Maybe one day they will heal each other's wound." Sanjay wants to work for L1 shop because he doesn't want to sleep. Sanjay was working in L1 shop. Then Bora comes there and says, "Oh my god, what you did? L1 will not like this way." Sanjay gets angry at Bora and drives him away. Mavi goes to Bora's restaurant and apologizes to him that she did not recognize him that day. Then she says she wants to work in this restaurant. First, Bora feels strange how such a successful woman will work in this restaurant, but then later he agrees. Paramount forces Muge to sell Gedi's sales to him. When Bora and Mavi are talking in the restaurant, Sanjay sees both of them from the window. Sanjay goes inside and asks Mavi, "What are you doing here?" Mavi says, "I am working here." Sanjay says, "You have not found any other place to work?" Bora comes and asks, "What is happening? Do you know him?" Mavi says, "Yes, I know him." Then Bora leaves from there saying that he has some work to do. Sanjay asks Mavi, "How do you know him?" Mavi tells Sanjay that both of them used to work in same sector. Sanjay does not like that Mavi asked Bora for work. Sanjay says, "I thought that both of us had shared our pain with each other, so we are starting to understand each other. But I was wrong." Saying this, he starts going from there. But Mavi stops him and asks to listen her for 2 minutes. Mavi says, "Did you feel bad because I asked Bora for help, not you?" Sanjay says, "Of course." Mavi says, "I have seen that you all interfere a lot in each other's life, but I don't like this. I want to solve my problem by myself, and I will leave from here after a few days. If you feel bad about it, so I won't force you to meet me." Sanjay says okay and goes from there. Muge calls Sanjay to Marina. Sanjay and Karman argues over Gedi's cells. Guven tells Karman that things are not done like this. You have hurried too much. Karman says, "Do you think this is just about share? I'm not like you, who is not worried about his granddaughter at all." Guven says, "Do you think I have no worries about her? And I will leave my granddaughter to that Sanjay?" Jelan walks out of the house without telling anyone. Melik is sitting in a corner sadly. Mavi keeps watching Melik. After Melik leaves from there, she comes and takes Melik's drawing book. She gets nervous seeing Melik's hair inside the book. L1 asks her what happened. She asks if Melik is okay. L1 says, "Yes, of course. What will happen to her?" Then Mavi leaves from there. Bora asks what happened to L1. L1 told everything about Mavi to Bora. When Zehra and Melik get out of the car, Guven meets them at the door and asks if he can come inside. Zehra informs Sanjay about this. Guven says, "Melik, I missed you so much." Melik asks Guven if he knows Nare's address. He says, "I don't know, but I will try to find out for you." Sanjay wants Guven not to come here again without telling him. Melik is waiting for Sanjay in her room, but he doesn't come. Melik sees him while leaving. Karman and Jalan patch up and both leave. Everyone is having dinner. Mavi calls Sanjay urgently and Melik doesn't like it. Mavi tells Sanjay that Melik is not well at all and shows Melik's hair to him. Sanjay leaves from there without saying anything. Sanjay comes to Melik's room and checks her hairs. He goes out from there and calls Mavi. He is very upset and starts crying and says, "I could not become a good father. Her mother had entrusted her with me." Mavi says, "Don't worry, come to the hut. Both of us will sit and talk about it, and we must find a solution." Harisa sends her driver to the hut and asks him to give every report about Sanjay. Melik hears conversation of Halise and driver, and she also goes to the hut. In the hut, Sanjay is sleeping with his head on Mavi's shoulder, and Melik sees both of them from the window. Melik feels very bad that Sanjay broke his promise to her. She cries and goes to her grandfather. Melik tells her grandfather, "I miss my mother very much. Please take me to her." Stay tuned. We will keep you updated, and don't forget to subscribe.